scientists at UCLA are researching the potential spread of COVID-19 from animal to human.
Nope.
I got it. It's fine.
It's just, it's so tricky because they really, please continue, Sam, and then.
All right, researchers at UCLA's Fielding School of Public Health want to better understand if veterinarians and other animal healthcare workers might be at risk for contracting the virus from animal patients. Researchers hope the study will give them a better understanding of the virus and how to prevent further exposure. It's already hard enough not going up to dogs when you see one in public, when you do get to go out in public. Now I hear this.
I mentioned this yesterday, guys, and I said I feel a little bad when people, you know, go for that fist bump, go for that handshake, and I put them off. I say no. People said, you know, I shouldn't feel that I'm being disrespectful. It's a matter of health, right? Same thing applies for my dog. I don't know how many times I've walked him this week where people literally come in and embrace him and touch him all over. They'll even give him kisses on the side of his nostril. It's like, I only give him kisses. What do you, and I have no idea what to do, guys. I don't know if I should pull my dog away from them. I don't know if I should just literally be really stern and say, hey, don't do that. These are grown people that are touching my dog and like rubbing their face like as if it's their dog. My dog's really lovable. He's really friendly. I just don't know how to avoid that situation. And I find this story very, very serious because if this disease can spread from pet to human, you know, I live at home with at-risk people at my house, and I just don't know how to go about it. I need suggestions.
What kind of leash?
Your dog. Yeah.
No, it's not that clear cut. I really wish it was. You clearly don't have a dog. So, I mean, it's
what
not that clear cut.
What leash do you have?
I've taken dogs on walks before. Like, you don't have to say, I know you like to take your dog on walk to get attention, so maybe that's what your issue is. But I think that, like, even my friend James, when we take, you know, Audrey on walks, people are usually trying to pet your dog before they actually just run up to it. But
so when you have them on the leash, can't you hold him right next to you?
I try to keep him real tight, but okay, for instance, there's other dogs too. And so he'll play with the other person's dog. And as they're in the middle of playing, that other person will then go and embrace my dog. And I don't know if I should just tug him away at that point. And it's, that seems really, really rude. But after the story.
This question has been asked a lot though, to like Dr. Barbara Ferrer and the LA Department of Public Health. And the idea that a dog can get COVID-19, we don't think that, I mean, there was like one story where a dog had COVID-19, but it ended up kind of being a fluke. But I guess the thing is, like, you know, could someone's respiratory droplets, our favorite word, spatter onto a dog and then ew, get off, you know, could it then transfer it to you? I just think that's got to be so.
It seems unlikely.
It's
it
such
really
a
does.
Small chance that, I mean, unfortunately, the likelihood that you'll probably get it somewhere else is probably higher. But at least that's what it sort of seems like when we ask the doctors in charge.
I guess I really wanted to share that part about the guy kissing my dog. That really stuck with really me, and I don't know how to get over that. So,
so what did you say? How did you react? Because if I were doing that and I noticed the owner's body language being like, I would feel bad and I would retreat and I would say,
she agrees. She agrees. Yeah. Yeah. My body language was definitely apprehensive. I was pulling away at the dog. But the guy just kept going for it. He kept getting closer and closer. And at that point, I told him I'm leaving. Bye, friend. And I kept walking. But if I wouldn't have kept walking, he would have just kept kissing mwah, mwah, mwah. I'm sorry, guys. I kept going. I keep going on about this. Please don't kiss other people's dogs. Please.
Except you kiss Cannoli, and I think that's okay.
Well, it's because we're very close. She's not a stranger. This was legit strangers, so.
Strangers kissing the dog is weird. I thought maybe you knew this neighbor or something, but that is odd.
Also, are we talking about like the guy leans over and plants one on the head of the pup, or like you're saying Wesley does full tongue into his mouth?
No, not full tongue. Wesley was very reserved. He knew that wasn't for him.
Or
like,
so this man came and just kissed the top of your dog's head.
Approved.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Yeah, and Wesley was there just.
You could do. No, you could give that bad boy a bath. So good.
I did not want her to bark again.
Good girl, you get a cookie.
Okay.
She's so cute with that diaper.